Oke, okay. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Welcome everyone. We're going to start our lesson today, but before that, I'm going to share the learning objectives and also step to success. So for today, the learning objectives is at the end of the lesson, students will be able to state the definition of drugs. Drugs, kamu tahu apa drugs? Drugs is ubat, dadah. And how to achieve this, we're going to define what drugs are and state the different kinds of drugs. And after that, explain that drugs can be dangerous. So these are the content for today. Now, okay, go over to your textbook and open up page 70. Okay, it's theme for personal health and environment. So in this topic, you're going to learn about what are drugs, what are some examples of medicinal drugs, how does smoking tobacco harm the body, how does alcohol harm the body, what are some examples of controlled drugs, how can natural events change the environment, how can human activities change the environment, and lastly, what are some ways we can conserve the environment. So all of these you're going to learn in this theme 4, health environment. So the first topic is going to be about drugs. So drugs, what are drugs? If you look at your textbook, it says there, drugs are chemicals that change the way the body works. So I'm sure every one of you have already taken drugs. It's not that, it's just that you don't notice that it's drugs. Misalnya kalau kamu demam. Kalau kamu demam, apa yang kamu buat? Where do you go? Where do you go when you feel sick? When you get sick, where do you go? Where do you go when you get sick?
Aku?
Yes, where do you go?
Klinik.
Klinik. When you go to the clinic, who do you see?
What?
Who do you want to meet when you go to the clinic?
Doctor.
Yeah, doctor. Why?
Because I'm sick.
Yes, you're going to ask doctor and you're going to ask him what's wrong with you because you're feeling sick, right?
Yes.
Well, the doctor will check your temperature. The first thing he will check is your temperature. Ceknya dulu tuh, whether kamu temperature itu panas kah ataupun udah panas kah, apakah so kalau sekiranya sudah panas artinya kamu demam kan? Itu dibukanya suruhnya buka mulut kan, suruhnya cek arah lidah kamu tuh ceknya kan? Actually lidah tuh ya cek kerongkong kamu tuh dalam mata diceknya kalau sekiranya kamu ada tonsilitis. Misalnya kalau kamu payah menelan apa, itu namanya tonsillitis. So, that, the doctor will prescribe you medicine. Ada ke tidak?
Ada.
Ya. So, obat itu sekarang kamu ambilkan tak? Dalam sehari misalnya 3 kali. So, that is already an example of drugs. Obat itu sebenarnya dadah tu. Tapi, bukan dadah yang bahaya. Sebenarnya dadah ini sebenarnya baik. Actually good. It's just that salah guna saja. Kalau penyalahgunaan dadah baru tak bahaya. There are certain drugs that you cannot take, but that are helpful. Ia boleh membantu badan kamu. So, if you can see here, medicinal drugs are drugs that help your body. Ini seperti apa yang kamu ambil nih? Ubat batuk, ubat selisma, ubat sakit kepala, Panadol, Paracetamol, everything ah. Ini sebenarnya ubat-ubatan ini menolong badan kamu. However, many drugs are harmful to the body. Ada juga yang tidak baik. Misalnya apa namanya? Namanya ialah harmful drugs. Harmful drugs ini can damage your health and affect the way that you think and act. Ini yang ini sebenarnya ada yang berbahaya nih. Yang indah bila jangan. Orang yang tanpa ada nasihat doktor. So harmful drugs can also be addictive. Yang bagus dalam bahasa dia boleh apa? Addictive-nya apa? Bahasa Melayunya apa? Betul.
Aku. Ketage.
Ketage. Bagus. Oke, okay, jadi sih apa contoh? Apa tahu? Can you please unmute your mic? Arisi, please tell me what are examples of harmful drugs that you know. Okay, maybe there's some technical error. Now, Parabetal, can you please answer?
Cocaine.
What example of harmful drugs that you know?
Cocaine.
Cocaine. Okay, good. But you can see here in the picture, this is alcohol. Alcohol, ini apa? Okay. Can everyone unmute your mic? I need your response. Unmute. Mic kamu tuh unmute.
Alkoholnya. Kalau butuhin ada.
Okay, Mas Sarah. Okay, Mas Sarah.
Yes. Yes.
Apa nih? What is this?
Alkohol.
Belinya apa? Ini apa? Demia. Ini apa nih?
Ya. Wah, ayunya.
Ah, the next. Apa nak minum nih?
Alam.
Minum apa?
Alkohol.
Ini boleh ya. Ini sebenarnya alkohol. Alkohol ini bolehnya ya boleh menghayalkan. It's dangerous.
Boleh menghayalkan.
Jadi Islam pun ini boleh haram nih, haram. Tidak boleh minum.
Haram.
Ada nggak sih?
Ya, you can see it's cannabis. Cannabis ini melayunya ganja. Oke, ganja. Barang-barang ini barang-barang terkawalnya, tidak boleh. Siapa yang didapati menyimpan akan ditangkapnya. Ini antibiotics.
Yeah.
Most doctors will give you if you are really really sick. And also, ini cough syrup ini. Okay, everyone understand? Some questions?
Yes.
You have any questions?
No.
Okay. Moving on, Next one. Okay, here, much more clearer explanation. As you can see from the graph, it says drugs is divided into two, medicinal drugs and harmful drugs. As a class, discuss which drugs on this page are medicinal drugs and which are harmful drugs. This one, methylamphetamine. Next. Medicinal kah, harmful drugs?
Harmful.
Yang bahasa yang tadi tahu apa? Kalau kamu tahu apa, Nek? Sabu, sabu. Sabu, Nek.
Sabu.
Painkillers.
Harmful.
Medicinal or harmful?
Medicinal.
Medicinal, it helps us. Okay, good. Tobacco.
Harmful.
From cigarettes. Coffee.
Medicinal.
Coffee ini sebenarnya ia melancarkan peredaran darah dalam badan. So it can be as a drug also. Medicinal kah? Harmful drugs?
Medicinal.
Karena kalau kamu ada gatal-gatal kulit kering, you use cream to moisturize your skin. So look at this video, Everyone look at this video. Thank you. About medicinal and harmful drugs. So as you can see, all drugs are actually helpful to us. It's just that if you use it wrongly, it will be dangerous. So that is why you can see a lot of people are very addictive. Misalnya yang bergadah atau yang berganja, yang bersabu, dia payahkan berhenti itu. Biasanya dia ketagih sudah. The important term for today, addictive itu artinya apa? Ketagihan, bahasa Melayunya ketagih. So next page. Okay, medicinal drugs. When you are unwell, a doctor will sometimes give you medicine to help you feel better or get well soon. Medicinal drugs can help the body in different ways. They can help to relieve pain, discomfort, and cure diseases. Let's take a look at some common medicinal drugs. First one is painkillers. Painkillers are medicine drugs that help to relieve pain, such as headache or injury. Common killers include paracetamol and aspirin. Okay, painkillers ini biasanya kena bagi kalau sekiranya kamu sakit kepala. Kalau kena bagi painkiller, ini membunuh rasa sakit atau mengurangkan. Ini pun mengurangkan. And the other one is cough syrup. Cough syrup is a medicine that can help you stop coughing when you have a common cold or the flu. Jadi ada orang kalau batuk untuk nanti, you need to take this cough syrup supaya it wouldn't affect your lungs. Okay, so let's look at video.
Medicinal drugs should be prescribed by a doctor or taken from the adult.
Example of medicinal drugs. Apa yang pentingnya medicinal drugs ni, kerana mesti kontrol. Misalnya kalau doktor suruh makan 1 biji sehari, kamu ambil 1 biji atau ambil 2, 3. Kalau kamu ambil 3, maksudnya apa? Overdose. Dan ia akan mengubah badan kamu tu. Kadang ada yang sampai tak sadar, pingsan. Okay, understand?
Yes.
So far any questions? Okay, so far kita ni sudah we already know what the definition of drugs. We already I've already explained to you what drugs are. I've already stated the different kinds of drugs. Now, explain that drugs can be different. We're going to do this last one, supaya we can achieve our learning objective. Going back to the textbook. Now, ini contoh-contoh medicine drugs, painkillers, cough syrup. Another one will be antibiotics. Okay, some illnesses such as tuberculosis, typhoid fever, and infections are caused by harmful bacteria. Ini bukannya demam demam biasanya, yang panas badannya nama turun langsung. So if you have an illness caused by bacteria, the doctor will often give you antibiotics. Membunuh kemampuan kamu. So, antibiotics are drugs that kill bacteria or to stop them from growing. As you can see from this picture, this cartoon picture, ini bacteria nya, ini bacteria. So, kalau kamu makan ubat atau ada mengandungi antibiotics. So, this antibiotics will kill the bacteria in your body. So, antibiotics do not work against viruses. Ingat tu, virus dia langsung dapat melawan. Tapi kalau bakteria, ia boleh membunuh. Tapi kalau virus, macam virus COVID ini, what we have now, virus COVID ini, belum lagi ada ubatnya tu, belum lagi ada ubatnya. Okay. Virus, virus coronavirus ini belum ada ubatnya. So, atun, pasal tak, pasal tu tak, pun dibagi memang dah dapat sembuh tu, So, antibiotics ini do not work against virus. Remember that. Therefore, antibiotics cannot be used to treat symptoms. Cannot be used to treat illnesses such as common cold, the flu, or HIV. Jadi, ini sangat-sangat kritikal ni. Untuk ubatnya. Kalau bagi antibiotics pun, dia mengasih, It will not do anything. There's no effect. So, antibiotics prescribed by the doctor. Kamu tidak boleh di kadai terus-terus. Tak, ini hanya akan diberikan oleh doktor saja. The doctor will prescribe the right type of antibiotic for the bacteria that are causing illness. Kita punya tahu ni. Apakah jenis bakteria yang ada dalam badan kamu tu? So, all antibiotics are labeled with instructions on how the antibiotics are able to be taken correctly. It is important to follow this instruction and finish the course. Biasanya kalau kamu demam, doktor bagi antibiotik makan untuk 3 harinya. Artinya walaupun kamu sudah sihat, kamu mesti masih makan habiskan. Biasanya kalau kamu tidak makan, sekiranya kamu demam berbalik, ubat itu tidak akan menolong kamu tu. That medicine will not help you at all. So you need to finish the medicine. Ya, doktor itu makan untuk 3 hari. Artinya you have to finish that medicine for 3 days. So that is the difference between antibiotics and medicine. Okay. If you finish the course of treatment, the bacteria may become resistant to the antibiotics. This means that the antibiotics will not work against the bacteria ill again. Seperti yang cuba terangkan tadi. Lihat ya. Okay. Next page. Ada medicinal drugs. Ada juga yang jenis lozenges ya, jenis yang ubat yang macam gula-gula untuk leher. Ada juga. Ada juga yang pakai cream. Cream can also used to treat. Ada lagi yang bertitik mata ataupun yang masuk ke hidung. So, apa yang hidung itu sempat pasal selisma, use nasal spray. Ini untuk sakit. Ini untuk sakit kulit. Ini untuk sakit leher. Macam-macam lah. There's a lot of medicinal drugs yang boleh membantu kita ni. And then, this lesson will be continue next tomorrow. Harmful drugs. We're going to do this tomorrow. So, untuk exercise hari ni, what I want you to do is, kamu buka workbook kamu.
Sekarang.
Workbook.
Lagi homework.
Page 56.
Berapa juga?
56. Cuba cek. 56, is it correct?
Berapa cilak?
56, buka surat 56.
Oke.
Juros.
Nah, juga.
Juros.
Lima enam.
Ini ni kalau lebihnya juga.
Kamu buka surat, kamu buat muka surat 56, 97 for today. Okay? Okay, any question? Any questions? Ada yang tak faham? You want to ask?
Tiga.
Tiga. Buat 56 saya kah?
56.
Tiga. Tiga. Tiga.
Yes. Okay.
Yep.
I thought I bought it back to school.
Kalau boleh, ada yang belum ambil foto, please ask your parents ambil harian ya. Guna tu, harian ini pun untuk esok pun guna tu. Please ask your parents to ambil di sekolah. Sampai hari ini sampai pukul 10:30. Everything clear?
Yep.
356. Okay. Ada apa? Ada soalan ke enggak? Everyone okay? Okay. Kalau okay, buat
pertanyaan.
Okay. Sudah paham, bikin punya tab. Okay. Okay. I'm gonna end the session. So whatever question you can ask in the group also.
Okay. I turned it on already. Bye.
Assalamualaikum.
Then I'm looking at you. People can see you. They can see you.
Bye.
They can see you.
Bye.